Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a look at the North American stock markets for Wednesday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are above fair value. We currently have the Dow up 70 points, so we are looking for some buying at the open on Wednesday morning. Now, I just heard in the background that Tiffany's reported, and it's not a stock I follow or a stock you should follow, but we were looking at the potential bottoming of the retail sector and a bullish reversal last week. And here Tiffany is down in the pre-market this morning. Obviously, investors were anticipating weakness from this stock ahead of time, so no surprises there. Now, we saw a lot of strength in technology stocks on Tuesday with the NASDAQ. Q's up 2% on the day. Of course, the NASDAQ is following the semiconductors higher, which made a new move for this move. The SMH ETF was up 2.42% yesterday, making a new high. And we're trying to break out above 56.25. If we can do that, then 57.81 would be our next target to the upside. Looking at the Qs themselves, this is a 60-minute chart of the Qs. We were trying to break out above this high, and we tried once, couldn't do it. We certainly did it yesterday. And this is the out of the three major U.S. indexes that I follow, this is the only one that has broken out above it. So we broke out above that high at the open and then continued one line higher. We got up to the 108.39 level. We're trying to break out above it. If we can do that on Wednesday, then 109.38 is our next target to the upside. Looking at the Dow Diamonds, you can see, again, this is the high we're trying to break out above. So far, we have not been able to do that. A little more strength in the S&P 500, and again, that's the high we're trying to break out above. Couldn't do it yesterday, but it looks like we're going to do it today. In the pre-market, we're trading, and this number is old by the time you see this video, so it'll definitely be different. 208.83 is above resistance there, so 209.38 is our next target to the upside. We've been talking about Apple Computer and specifically the big open gap. Yesterday, we were talking about the bottom of the open gap as being a price target and an area of resistance at 98.71. Yesterday, we got as high as 98.09. In the pre-market this morning, we're trading at 98.39. And so there's a strong chance that the market could stop on a dime if Apple can't break through the bottom of that open gap. Looking at the U.S. bank stocks, they had a nice day yesterday, still behind the rest of the market. There's Bank of America, Citigroup, and then we've got finally Wells Fargo jumping on board with a new buy signal yesterday. So let's see if we can see continued action, upward action in the U.S. banks. Canadian banks, it's earnings season right now, and earnings have started to come out. There's the TSX Financial Services Index making a new high yesterday. We're trying to break through 250, got as high as 249.82. If we can take out 250, 256.25 is our next target to the upside. Looking at the individual Canadian banks, Bank of Montreal making a new high yesterday, Bank of Nova Scotia, a little bit of a drag. Back on a buy signal, there's an open gap to deal with on the way up. There's CIBC making a new high yesterday, trying to break through 103.13. If we can do that, 106.25 is our next target to the upside. Then we've got the National Bank, like Bank of Nova Scotia, now back on a buy signal. Again, like the Bank of Nova Scotia, we're looking to see what will happen at that open gap. There's the Royal Bank, not making a new high for this move, actually hitting the previous high and stopping. 78.93 was the high a couple of weeks ago. It was the high yesterday. If we can take that out, then 81.25 is our next target to the upside. And last up, there's the TD Bank making a new high for this move, trying to break out above 57.03. We closed at 57. 57.81 is our next target to the upside on the daily charts. Now, crude oil is still looking pretty healthy, and it looks like we are going to be able to hit $50 this week. But the energy stocks are not moving in sync. And if we look at the Amex Oil and Gas Index, you can see it's not doing very well at the moment. Still looking for a buy signal. We need to close above 11.2014. We got it closed at 11.1318 yesterday. So still waiting for a buy signal there. Canadian energy stocks still on a buy signal. No change in trend there. So looking to see if we can take out the recent high. Now, Husky Energy and Imperial Oil have been a drag on this sector. There's a couple of the really big cap stocks. Imperial Oil generated a buy signal yesterday, but you know, not sure if I'd want to take it. I'd certainly be looking at some other energy stock to follow more than Imperial Oil. Looking at some of the U.S. listed energy stocks, some of the foreign companies not doing well at the moment. Certainly when you line it up with the price of crude oil. There's PetroChina, there's Royal Dutch Shell, and there's Total. None of them looking very healthy at the moment. When you compare it to Exxon, which appears to be moving right in sync with the price of crude oil. Last up, looking at the gold sector, the gold was down yesterday, looking to see if it can hold at 1218.75. If it can't, then 1187.50 is our next target to the downside. There's the XAU and the TSX Gold Index, both on sell signals at the moment. So I would imagine, without looking through every stock in either of those sectors in the U.S. and in Canada, I would imagine that they're all on sell signals right now. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Looks like we're going to have another good day. Big line in the sand. What's the market going to do at the bottom of that open gap in Apple? Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.